Hello, everybody. This is Style Yoshi, and welcome back for some more Backyard Baseball 1997. The day is here, the All-City Playoffs. Oh, I'm pumped, but at the same time, I'm pretty nervous. We went 14-0 in the regular season, and we faced the wild card Melonheads as we took the league championship, but not all of it. If you want to be the All-City playoff champion, you got to win a best 2 out of 3. And something tells me there's going to be some wild freaking games. So before we do anything, didn't forget it this time. All right, so here we go. Game one. Wait, hang on. Let me check the strat real quick. All right, we good. Yeah, we good. Same strat as last time. Same lineup as last time. All right. Game one of the All-City Playoffs is about to begin. The Blue Hornets riding a perfect season versus the humongous Melonheads. Nobody has been able to compete with the Hornets, but the Melonheads want to show why they're here and forget about their first two meetings against the Blue Hornets. Here we go. Let's do it.
This next one's a strike guaranteed.
Angelo Del Vecchio is on the mound. And here we go. The All-City Playoffs about to begin. So Angelo will step up, and here's the first pitch. Swing. That's a ground ball to the right side. Achmed, it's a race to the bag. Got him. And that's out number one. Fred Benson, who did most of the damage for the Melonheads offense in the two games against Angel and the Blue Hornets. Oh, she pops them up this time around. Sydney makes the grab, and that's out number two. Two pitches, two outs. Angel couldn't ask for a better start so far. But here's Jane Davis. Fred Benson, also the league leader in slugging percentage, and also one of the top players in home runs, RBIs, hits. He was a monster of the regular season. Here's the pitch. That's in there for a strike. Angela's heat. Looking good. It was right in the spot where we wanted it. Here's the 0-1. Alright. Swing. That's a liner and a right. Pete Wheeler on the run. Makes the grab. And that's out number three. And a good start. Three up, three down for Angelo Del Vecchio. It's a 1-2-3 inning. And nice defense by the Hornets, where at times it can be questionable, but for the most part, it's done really well for the Hornets. Here's Luann Louis. I think she led the league in batting average during the regular season because she gets on base with all these bunts, grounders. Oh, speaking of bunts, here's one. Oh, that's foul. And out of play. So, it's 0-1. Bottom of the first. The Hornets want to get off and running like they have been these past few games. Another pitch. That's a bunt right into the dirt. Couldn't have been any better. And Luann has an infield hit. And it's a nice start for this offense as Luann, Vicky, or Luann, Vicky, and Pete. All three of them have tremendous speed. But here's Stephanie Morgan. Not really an underwhelming season, but not an overwhelming season. So that's a pitch outside for ball one. Luann's going to get there easily. No throw to second. So we got a possible run on second base here. Here comes the pitch, the 0-1. And we'll take that one for strike one. Chad Kopel on the mound. He was pretty solid during the regular season. I don't know his numbers exactly. And that's outside for ball two. The Hornets, when they work the count, are the most dangerous team in the league. Here's the pitch. In there for ball three. 3-1. Stephanie just waiting for her pitch. This team exceeds so well when they work the count. And that's in there for strike two. So we'll probably try and get a hit and run here, unless it's a ball. Swing, that's a looper. Right in the center, that's a base hit up the middle. Luan Louis rounding third. We got an RBI single. The Hornets are off and running. And it's out of play as the play to home goes AWOL. And for the record books, Stephanie's got a RBI double. Hornets are off and running. You were worried about some of the rust, because I haven't played this game in a while, guys. But no rust at all. Whew. Shake it off. Shake it off, boys and girls. Shake it off. So Stephanie Morgan with a solid hit up the middle. It was a nice hit. Now Pete Wheeler steps in. That's up there for a strike. All right. So couldn't have asked for a better start. Luan gets on, gets a steal, and then a double off an error. An RBI double off an error for Stephanie Morgan. It would have been an RBI single, but who knows? Here's the 1-1 to Pete Wheeler. Pete Wheeler sends one into left field. That one looks shallow, though. He got under it, and that's caught. Stephanie went for whatever reason, but she's going. Okay. Stephanie Morgan got the third. The left fielder, I guess, didn't notice, and Stephanie Morgan advanced to third. And here's Angela Delvecchio.
You guys in the outfield.
I think she had one or two home runs all season, but it don't matter. She also had a bunch of RBIs. She hit pretty well, and her pitching was humongous the regular season. Oh, that's driven into right field. Could it be? One pitch. That one is gone. Angela Delvecchio on the first pitch. We got a two-run shot. The Hornets are off and running here in game one. We haven't missed a beat. Woo! Angela goes 1-2-3 pitching. Hits a two-run shot. Love it. And the Hornets blow it open early. It's 3-0. A sack fly for Pete Wheeler. And the Hornets are up 3-0. Oh, my goodness. Couldn't ask for a much better start. Here comes Pablo. He's had his spurts. But he has showed consistency in hitting. They weren't humongous hits like home runs, doubles, triples. But they were like RBI singles, and he's done everything right. That's in there for strike one. Pablo Sanchez. Trying to get the ball rolling here for the playoffs. That's it. That's foul. 0-2. So Angela Delvecchio, two home runs all season, gets one in here in game one for the postseason. And that's just inside for a ball. That looked like a good pitch. I don't think Pablo would have gotten any good contact out of that. Here's the 1-2. Inside for ball two. So we couldn't have asked for a better start, my friends. So, here comes the 2-2. Swing, that's a liner into left. That's it for a base hit. That'll go to the wall. Pablo thinking two. That's a throw to second. Beautiful throw. Pablo will go back. Makes it, and he's safe at first. With one out, and that's a base hit. Here comes Sydney Weber. The consistent of the Weber sisters. But we all know the comeback, the most improved player of the year is, and that would be Ashley Weber. Swing, that's driven but foul. Hitters are getting really good contact off of Chad Kopel early. Trying to go for the hit and run here. Here comes the 0-1. Swing, that's a blooper into right. That's, ooh, this could be two. There's one. And two, and that'll end the inning. As Sydney Weber bounces into a double play. But as the inning ends, the lead is intact. And the damage was already done. Stephanie Morgan with an RBI double. And then Angela Delvecchio with a two-run shot. And the Hornets are up 3-0 as Angela goes back on the field for the second inning. Seriously, we couldn't have asked for a better first inning. And for Angela Delvecchio, to work with a 3-0 lead, it's hard enough to get one run She's given up two runs all season in one game. She's only given up two runs in a game all season at most. It's hard enough to get one. Two is rough. But three against Angela, we'll see if she performs in the playoffs. The 1-1. Oh, there's a pop-up. Angela says she's got it. Makes the catch. That's out number one. So, here's Karen Donato stepping in. Here's the payoff. Angela in cruise control. Strike one. So many first pitch strikes. That's what you look for in a pitcher. And Angela's done it. She wants the heat. Here's the 0-1. It's outside for a ball. 1-1. Oh, man. Angela. Here comes the 1-1. Swing and a miss. 1-2. Fooling the hitter there. Here comes Angela. Wants that strike pitch. Here comes the 1-2. Got her swinging for her first strikeout of the night. As Angela. It's a strikeout. Well, coming up, only her 12th pitch of the game. And it's already been an inning and a third. Here comes the pitch. That's inside for ball one. So, rare miss. Angela's fastball can get a little crazy. But all around, she is a quality starting pitcher. Strike one. We've also sat her the next two of the next three games, and then she just completed it out in the last game. Here comes the 1-1. Swing! I missed 1-2. Good heater there. So the 1-2, Angela trying to start this game with six straight outs. The 1-2. Swing! I missed! She got her! And that'll end the inning. Another 1-2-3 inning for Angela. We've said that so many times. Here comes Ahmed Khan, who's had a power surge as of late.
This one's out of here.
What is it, 7 home runs in his last 8 games? It's been ridiculous. He's been ridiculous. And Ahmed holds off that. He loves the outside pitch. But Ahmed, the 1-0, coming up from Chad Kopel. Ooh, that's a liner into right. That's going to drop to the wall. And Ahmed will have a single to start the inning. Don't want to go on that ball. As Ahmed starts with a single in this inning. Here comes Ashley Weber, who has been ridiculously good since getting her first hit. Then she went 0-for-3 the next game, and we were kind of worried, and then she got 4 hits, including 3 RBIs. Ugh. She's been an awesome story for this team. Oh, Ahmed trying to go. Oh, he trips. That's never a good thing. Oh, going back. They're trying to chase him down. Oh, he trips again. And he's tugged out as he's caught stealing. Not good. As the catcher has a nice arm there. I don't think they have a nice enough arm to get our top speed players out. As we didn't see a throw for Luann in the first. Swing, that's a liner down the line. Base hit in the left. So Ashley Weber continues her hitting surge. I thought that was going to bounce away. But Ashley gets a one-out single. Here comes Vicky Kawaguchi. Behind the plate, she's done really well. She doesn't have the strongest arm in the game, but she gets the job done. And Vicky trying to advance Ashley Weber to clean slate the playoffs. Vicky, no, nothing there. And it's 0-1. All right. Now we're trying to manufacture runs. This is what the middle to the bottom of the lineup can do. Here comes a bunt to the right side. That looks pretty good. Can Vicky beat the throw? She does. We got 2 on with 1 out. We got the top of the order coming up as Luann Louis is on deck. Or is up. I'm sorry. Luann Louis in. We're also going to try a hit and run here. Another bunt. This is what the speed characters can do. We just got to rely on Ashley Weber to hustle to third, but we want to bunt to the right side. Nothing there. That's ball one. Wayne got that infield hit to get the offense started for the Hornets. Going for the bunt. Into the right side. It's a beauty. Ashley Weber hustling to third, and we got bases loaded with one out. And we got Stephanie Morgan, who got a double her last time up. And it was an RBI double off an error. Originally a single, but then an error. So the Melonheads,
as you can tell, I've modeled my stance off the great Babe Ruth.
With a bases loaded jam here in the second. That's outside for ball one. So Stephanie wants to keep the pedal going for this offense. You don't want to give any leeway, especially in the playoffs. That's inside for ball, or strike two, or strike one. Bleh, I can clearly announce today, guys. So, the 1-1. That's a grounder to the right side. The throw home in time. And it's a force out at home. But Pete Wheeler will step in. Ashley Weber was called out at home. Smart play. Here's Pete Wheeler, who had a sack flies last time up, although that won't do the job this time as we have two outs.
I'm gonna hit a touchdown.
Pete Wheeler. In the batter's box. That's in there for a strike up in the zone. Alright. Relying on Pete Wheeler to get the job done. It's inside for ball one. With Pete Wheeler, you kind of gotta wait for his right pitch. He's around the outside of the zone. He actually hit the inside as well. That doesn't look good. All right, ball two. 2-1. Pete Wheeler heading the count. All right, the 2-1. Ball three, Pete Wheeler. Expect him to get a good pitch here, so probably going to open up with swing. Swing. Ooh, he fouls that one off. We got a full count. Runners will go on contact. The 3-2. Ball four. That's a walk. And now it's 4-0 Hornets. Good stuff. A bases loaded walk, an RBI walk for Pete Wheeler. And here comes Angelo Delvecchio. Hit a two-run shot her last time up. She hit it just over the wall. But showing why she can hit so well. So here comes Chad Kopel. That's up there for a strike. Angelo can't really hit well up in the zone. She's really good from here down. The 0-1. In there for strike two. Now you got to protect the plate. You're hoping for a pitch here, but at the same time, got to keep it alive. That's ball one inside. 1-2. Sorry, I just got to move this. All right. 1-2 coming up. Chad Kopel trying to get out of a jam. Misses again. It's 2-2. You do not want to extend this inning. You want to get these guys out early. But the Hornets making so much. Oh, swing and a miss. Struck her out. Angela couldn't make contact there, and the side is retired. Three left on. But Pete Wheeler worked a bases loaded walk to extend the lead to 4-0 here in the second. As we go to the top of the third, Angela Delvecchio was 12-0 in the regular season. Here comes the payoff. Swing and a miss. Omar Stefano wanting to make a spark for this Melonheads offense. The 0-1. That's fouled away, 0-2. So, Angelo with a nice start here. Here comes the 0-2. Swing, just got a piece of that. Nice cut. And the count stays 0-2 as we battle again. Angela saying she wants the heat. Misses down low for ball one. All right. Here comes the 1-2. Got him looking for number 3. On the night for Angela. Here comes Chad Kopel, the starting pitcher. Has not performed well in this game. Here comes the pitch. Strike one. This offense has gotten better and better as each game went by. And you now see the end result. This offense can score at will, where at first it was a little shaky, but at times when they were down, they would come right back, especially against that game against the All-Stars. And that's ball one. The All-Stars took a 2-1 lead, and it looked like the All-Stars had it in the bag. All of a sudden, they switched pitchers. Even though they switched pitchers, the reliever was doing well. Swing and a miss. Got her looking for number 4. Back-to-back strikeouts to start this inning. Fernando Diaz steps in. And Angelo Delvecchio wants to start this game with 9 straight outs. Here comes the pitch. Swing, that's driven into left field. And that one's going foul. Angelo left one hanging there. So, here comes the 0-1. Swing and a miss 0-2. But like I said, it was 2-1 All-Stars. And then Ahmed Khan comes right back with a home run to tie the game. And then after that, we all know what happens in the 5th. It was an awful inning. Swing and a miss! Got him swinging. Striking at the side, and that's number 5 for Angelo Delvecchio as the middle of the order steps up. Pablo Sanchez in. Had a nice liner into left. Start his postseason. So, Pablo, he didn't get all of the home runs. It was more Ahmed Khan with the big bat. Swing, that's a line drive into right center. That's through. Pablo Sanchez making really good contact here. So, Pablo Sanchez and the throws keep getting blocked. But Pablo sticks with a single. So, leadoff single for Pablo Sanchez. That's always nice to see. Here's Sydney Weber. And let's turn down the volume a little bit. And here comes the pitch. That's in there for a strike, 0-1. Sydney Weber grounded out her last time up into a double play. Swing, that's a blooper to right path, and that's in for a base hit. Pablo's safe at second, so is Sydney. Right in the gap. That was a pretty good hit. Back-to-back hits to start those innings. Here's Ahmed Khan. Led the league in home runs. Led the league in home runs, RBIs. He can do it all. That's upstairs for ball one. Ahmed, always willing to work this count, unless he sees a beautiful pitch. 2-0 to Ahmed. You do not want to mess with Ahmed Khan. You don't want to give any pitches to him, or else he'll just yank one. Like this one. Whoa, he got under it. Oh, man, that will go up, 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 and into the seats. Third baseman gave it a look. Oh, Ahmed surely wants that one back. He got under it, and it went foul. The 2-1, strike two, 2-2. The 2-2 coming to Ahmed. Swing! That one's belted into right! That is long! Gone! He crushed that one! Fastball on the outside part of the plate. He won't miss from there. Ahmed Khan with a rocket! Oh my goodness, 682 feet! I think that's a new record. I think that beats Pablo's. But oh my goodness, the Hornets lead 7-0 here in game one. Oh my! Hawkbit wasted no time, and here comes Ashley Weber. Middle of the order, getting it done. Unreal stuff. Oh, snap. Sorry. That's in there for a strike. I clicked OBS by accident. I'm sorry, guys. But, here we go. It's in there for strike two. And now Chad Copel with 700 runs is out getting relieved by Colleen Klinker. Here comes the 0-2. Swing that's fouled away. Ashley fights it off. Oh, my. The 0-2. Ball one. That just missed. Whew. Wow. A 1-2. Swing. That's a little blooper on the right side. Second baseman will make it. The throw to first. In time for out number one. Here comes Vicky Kawaguchi stepping in. 7-0 Hornets here in game one. They're asserting their dominance here against the Melonheads. In there for ball one. The 1-0. Going for the bunt. Ooh, she gets it. First baseman has to run to first. Oh, they knock into each other. So, it's an infield hit. A bunt base hit for Vicky Kawaguchi. I don't think the first baseman would have gotten there in time anyway. Here comes Luann Louis, 2-for-2.
This one's for you, Teddy.
This lineup can do so much. Here comes the opening pitch. Oh, Luann. Looking for a butt. Oh, that's a beauty. That's fair. The throw to first. What a gun! And that's out number two. But Vicky advances. So rare out for Luann Louis. And here comes Stephanie Morgan, who's 2-for-2. Everybody hits. Woohoo!
Okay, I'm just going to keep my eye on the ball and knock the cover off of it.
It's a home run fiesta for the Hornets right now. Two outs. Vicky on second. Swing. Ooh, she got under that one. Pitcher makes the catch. That's out number three. The sat is retired. But Ahmed Khan with a 682-foot home run. And the Hornets out and running 7-0 here in game one. Angela, perfect through three. Here comes the pitch. Swing and a miss, 0-1. She got her to chase. Five strikeouts for Angela. Swing and a miss, 0-2. She's just unhittable right now. She started the regular season with a perfect game. And she wants to start the postseason on the right foot with a win. Swing and a miss, got her number six. Angela DelVecchio on fire. Here comes Fred Benson. Top of the fourth. Angela in cruise. Reeling and dealing control. I just made that up. Don't quote me on that one. Swing. A popped up again. Sydney will race to it. Makes the catch. That's out number two. I thought that was dropping for a second, but Sydney's like, oh, I got it. Angela, two outs. Two quick outs, that is. It's up high for ball one. Oh. Sheesh. Who knew it would go this well? I mean, I didn't have doubts, but 7-0 lead in the top of the fourth. Throw to first. In time. A 1-2-3 inning for Angela DelVecchio. 12 straight outs to start game one and the playoffs. She's virtually unhittable. And we got the middle of the order. Oh, boy.
I'm going to hit a touchdown.
Pete Wheeler worked a walk in the second. It was a bases loaded walk. Ooh, Pete Wheeler went chasing there. It's 0-1. So, Pete Wheeler. Here comes the pitch. Swing fouled away 0-2. Pete Wheeler fighting for that pitch. Wants to get his first hit of the playoffs. Everybody except for Pete Wheeler has a hit. Kind of feel sad. That's just inside for ball one. That was pretty darn close, to be honest. 0-2. Oh, he makes contact there. That's a little blooper. Pete Wheeler, always a tough out. The throw to first. Not in time. Pete's got an infield hit. Here comes Angelo Del Vecchio. Got a two-run home run.
I'm gonna smack this one.
Back in the first. Pete Wheeler's on base, and boy, can he run. Second in the league in steals. One behind. Oh my goodness, does she get another one? No, it drops. Pete Wheeler's going to go for home. Angela Del Vecchio's got an RBI single. It's 8-0. I thought she had another one. That was around the same position where in her first at-bat it was. That's where the first pitch was located for her. I can't word it. That was around the same area where she hit it out into the plate. Oh, man. I can clearly talk today, guys. Blah. Blah. But an RBI single for Angelo Del Vecchio. Her fourth RBI. Or no, her third RBI of the game. That's in there for strike one. Pablo Sanchez, 2-for-2 with two singles. Pretty hard hit singles as well. So, swing. Ooh, that's driven at a left center. That's going back. Ooh, and that's caught. Oh, Angela fell. I don't think she has the strength. No, it gets away, and that's out of play. Angela will take a base. It might be two since she was on her way back. Nah, it's just one, but Angela gets the second. Pablo with a fly out, but another error, another throwing error. It bounced on the first baseman and got away. Here's Sydney Weber. So one out. Angela on second. I think a line drive and a right would be perfect. Ball one. Angela will get back. I don't think we're going to ask her to steal since she's pitching. I thought she had another one. Ooh, she tried to go power there, but gets a big pop-up. Catcher doesn't make the catch. Another error for the Melonheads. Oh, man. That's embarrassing. And here's Ahmed Khan. Last time up, he got a three-run shot. And he's in position for another one to make this game so out of reach for the Melonheads. Oh, he got under it. Oh, no, that's not good. That's an infield fly for out number two. He got anxious at the plate. We got anxious at the plate, and that's an out. Here comes Ashley Weber.
I'm going to crush this one.
Ashley Weber and Sydney Weber, both contact hitters. Although I feel like they can show their power every once in a while. Swing, that's a liner into left. That's in the gap. That'll get past the left fielder. Everybody will be safe. So we got two outs. We got Angela, our pitcher, on third. And here's Vicky Calgucci. I think we want to work the count here. Let's see what we can do. It's in there for a strike. And only one strikeout for this team. The 0-1 upstairs for ball one. So, Vicky wants to work this count here and hopefully get a walk. Both Weber sisters on. It's in there for strike one and two. Now you don't go for the bunt, you go for the contact. Hopefully fight a couple balls off, work the count, and get a walk. Swing. Ooh, that's a big bouncer to the right side. The throw home in time. That'll end the inning. Runners left on, but we got an RBI single from Angelo Delvecchio. It's 8-0 Hornets through four, as the Hornets have scored in every inning. As Angelo gets back out there to work here in the fifth. She has a perfect game through four innings. Holly Evans hopes to break it. That's a bunt. Angela works it. Throw to first. Nice throw. That's out number one. The bunt doesn't work. Karen Donato steps up. Here comes the pitch from Angela. Swing. That's a liner to the left side. Stephanie makes the play. Throw to first. In time for out number two. The defense showing off its skills. Stephanie with a nice play. Here comes Colleen Klinker, the active pitcher. Considering she's pitched well for the Melonheads. She wants that heater, even though she's pretty tired. Swing. Ooh, that's tipped foul. 0-1. Oh, boy. Who wants some of this Hornets? No, nobody wants them. That's outside for ball one. Angela. Here comes the pitch. The 1-1. Swing and a miss. 1-2. That looked high. But who knows. Here comes the 1-2 pitch. Got him! Swing and that'll end the inning. Another 1-2-3 inning for Angela Delvecchio. And the top of the lineup is due. Lorraine Louis stepping up.
This one's for you, Ted.
Three outs away from a perfect game. Who would have thought? Payoff, Luann Bunting. She's always a tough out. Throw to first. Not in time. Luann's on. Stephanie Morgan steps up.
Okay, I'm just going to keep my eye on the ball and knock the cover off of it.
So Luann can steal here. She's already got a steal in the game. That's our grounder to the pitcher. Nice play. Throw to second. Out number one. To the first. Out number two. Double play. Not a good pitch to swing at, but it was right around her area, but she didn't get good contact. And that turned into a double play. So the Mountheads trying to get out of this inning. And here comes Pete Wheeler, who's another speed threat. And guess what? Angela's on deck. So, you want to get Pete Wheeler out.
What am I supposed to do again?
Hopefully you get him out. That's way up high. That's ball one. Sorry, I'm getting texts. Go away! No, I'm just kidding. It's my girlfriend. 1-0, and that's a swing and a miss. Pete Wheeler. Tough to find contact, but when he gets it, it feels like a power hit. That's a grounder to the right side. Throw, a nice play. Pete Wheeler's in there for another infield hit. So, Pete Wheeler, and here comes Angela. Both of her hits have gotten RBIs, just throwing it out there. So, if you're the Melonheads, you do not want to give anything outside to Angela. Upstairs for strike one. Here comes Pete Wheeler, and he'll take it easily. I think he has more speed than Luann. That's just my guess. He's that good. That's a pitch way down the outside, and that's ball one. Angela's got a two-run home run, an RBI single. Oh, she crushed that one! Oh, my goodness, but it's foul. Oh, my. She is ready to play, folks. Pitching, hitting, and fielding. Swing, she fights that one off. One and two still. Oh, just imagine if she clocked that one. Oh, that would have been beautiful. One, two, that looks tough. Oh, strike three called. And that will end the inning. And the Hornets don't score for once. But top of the sixth, Angela with a perfect game bid. She's more concentrated than that. Here comes Omar Stefano. The bottom three for the Melonheads. It's Angela conserving energy throughout. That's ball one inside, a rare ball. Angela wants the heat. Here comes the 1-0. Way outside, but he swung at it. It's 1-1. They just keep giving her those strikes. You don't want to give her that. Just give her that much of an edge. Here comes the 1-1. Swing, and I missed 1-2. Nice rebound there from Angela, who seems unhittable. Here comes the 1-2. Swing, that's a grounder. Right to Angela. Oh, this is going to be a tough play. Sydney, the throw in time for round number one. Sydney helping Angela that time. Two outs away. Chad Copel, the starting pitcher for this game, didn't last all that long. Swing and a miss. 0-1. Nice slow ball. That's her best pitch. The 0-1. Oh, that's ball one outside. Looked pretty good, but umpire didn't make the call. Probably just a little outside. Here comes the 1-1. Swing and a miss. 1-2. Angela keeping it up. She wants that left hook up in the zone. She loves that pitch. It's way too high. 2-2. The 2-2. Swing and a miss. Got him for number eight. One out away from a perfect game in the All-City playoffs. Oh, man. They just can't do anything against her. Fernando Diaz, the last hope. Here comes the pitch. Way outside of where she wanted it, but it's in there for a strike. But okay. The 0-1 coming up. Ball one inside, just missing. Come on, Angie. I call her Angie. The 1-1, strike two, one strike away from her ninth of the night, and a perfect game. The 1-2. Swing and a miss. She got him. A perfect game in the playoffs. She started the regular season with a perfect game, and she starts the playoffs with a perfect game. Unreal stuff. Oh my goodness, I didn't think I would get two in one playthrough. That's unreal. Oh my gosh. Angela, 9 strikeouts. The Hornets get 19 hits, 8 runs. 6 of them, or 5 of them came off of a 2-run home run and a 3-run home run. Unreal stuff. Check it out. Let's keep on moving. 18 batters faced. No hits allowed. No walks. 11 balls, 41 strikes. She was that good. Only 52 pitches. That's ridiculous. So we take a 1-0 series lead as we're hoping to win the All-City playoffs and move on to the national championship, I believe. Yeah, But, this... I don't know what else to say, guys. Angela with a perfect game. She got a home run. She had 3 RBIs, speaking of which. So, oh well. Oh my goodness. We're up 1-0 in the series. One more game and we're the All-City champions. So, anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate it. Tune in next time to see if we clinch or not and suffer our first loss of the season. We don't want that. We want to clinch this ASAP. So, thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you all in the next one. Laters!